Maura's story actually begins 20 years ago, when I was told by doctors I would not be able to get pregnant due to health issues. Imagine my shock when I discovered I was pregnant in October of 1999. This was the first time that Maura defied immense odds. When I was 5 months pregnant, I was in a major car crash. In fact, I needed to be cut out of the car, and the odds of such a fragile being surviving that were so low. Yet, despite being told that they could not find her heartbeat for a couple of hours, she indeed came through unscathed, defying the odds yet again. Months later, she was born, but the umbilical cord was wrapped around her neck 3 times. I can still see the doctor swiftly unlooping the cord. And yet, she needed no medical assistance and was declared vivacious and strong. Fast forward to kindergarten. When I was told by her teachers they could not understand her, and she would need speech therapy from the special school district. Despite this obstacle, she surprised her teachers and therapists with her swift improvement. I prepared myself for a long process, and it was finished faster than anyone could have anticipated. Let's fast forward to second grade. Despite being a good student, she was deficient in reading. She simply could not read and was still at kindergarten level. She started remedial reading, group tutoring, and individual tutoring throughout the week. Again, I knew this would take time, so I was surprised to see her get off the bus just 2 months later, her head, her face buried deep in a book. Maura had surprised everyone and overcome an immense obstacle again. In fact, her reading level jumped from kindergarten to fourth grade in just 1 year. Once she overcame her problems, she drank books in as if they were water, and she had spent her life in the desert. Over and over, this daughter of ours has shown herself to be able to overcome any obstacle and defy all the odds. As she begins this new phase of her life, I can barely wait to see what new things she will accomplish and how she will surprise us all in the coming years. Please welcome our daughter, Maura. So you need more explanations. If you miss the basics, you'll be confused later on. In class, I normally listen because I get it the first time. Although one time, we were doing a math problem where you had to multiply both sides by 3, and I got the wrong answer because I forgot a step. And when I asked the teacher if they explained it and I got it, I had to make a decision to ask for a deeper understanding. I have a friend in my science class. We were going to make a switch for a project. They didn't understand how. I tried to explain it to them, but they didn't get it. So I told them to ask the teacher, but they didn't want to. They struggled with electricity throughout the class. Because of this, they may never understand how to make an electric switch, although they do now. In the ethical society, there are 2 core values that are most important to me. I am free to choose what I believe, and I am free to question. I think every human being should be free to make their own decisions. If you aren't, then you are enslaved to other people's desires. In my free time, I like to read dystopian or supernatural fiction. One of my favorite books I've read is Divergent by Veronica Roth. In the book, everyone is separated into five different groups at age 16. They all drank a serum, and it put them through an assimilation with a series of choices.